Because I was so worked up in my own ego and about what I'm doing and my purpose and am I living up to my potential. It became very, very overbearing. I was overbearing on myself, and it was hard to make creative decisions from there. And so by shifting the focus, starting to talk to other people and ultimately get the idea for my podcast where I interview people and have them tell their stories, it was like such a relief to shift the focus and work with empathy and compassion that way and develop greater sensitivity to what other people are dealing with. And that kind of brought me to where I am now.
That is a very inspiring story. And I've been lucky to see parts of it. I can also say, like, hearing some of the stories that are shared on your podcast, like, it's really bringing that empathy out. You're digging deep. What has been some of the biggest outcome of that for you so far? You're almost 25 episodes in. What does that even mean? Like, what did it bring to your life? If you can picture that for us.
Yeah, it's a really, really good question. So one thing that it's brought back into my life is the ability to follow my curiosity. I think business and technology was interesting for a relatively short time, especially because I could easily imagine how I could make money doing it. And so I was like, yeah, I'm interested in that and I'll follow that path for a while. But unless you are truly passionate about something, eventually your curiosity will wear off. So by shifting my focus away from technology, away from business, into the podcast and into people, I gained access to this infinite pool of curiosity that I have, which is ultimately my curiosity about the human condition, which never ends. That is endless. You know, what does it mean to be human? What does it mean to exist as a mortal and face certain death? How do we cope with that? How do we build relationships in spite of the fact that everything is temporary? How do we choose what to spend our life on? These are questions that I don't think have singular answers that people answer in all kinds of very interesting and dynamic ways. And so for me, it's a privilege to be able to follow my curiosity and just get people's answers. And I just want to keep going.
Please do. Because we need a lot of those stories coming out the way you're doing it. I'm curious. You mentioned curiosity. Do you have like specific ways to kind of like digest these things for yourself? Like, how do you like follow that curiosity and bring it into action, or somehow want to plan sort of an action plan for it in future? Like, do you have a process? Is there a way you like to share with us?
Yeah. So really interesting questions. And there's a few categories of what I'm doing that I could focus on and how I answer. But like the first element is just the stories themselves. People from throughout history, from every part of the earth, pretty much all of the inhabited land of the planet, have stories that they've passed on through generations as oral traditions and eventually as written traditions. And almost all of them carry a few commonalities. A central hero is a very, very, very common device, literary device. But beyond just having a central hero, so many stories have that hero born into a moment of stability and calm, and then have that calm disrupted and taken away in some way. And sometimes it's taken away by their own actions. Sometimes it's by things that are out of their control. But we have this image of the Buddha born into relative wealth and luxury as a prince and being in the stable walled gardens of his palace and then going out into the world and having that vision of stability disrupted. This is also true of Jesus Christ.